Welcome to MegaNet Gaming, and today's review is going to be on PlayStation 1 game, Star Wars, Masters of Teras, released in North America, October 31st of 1997, developed and published by LucasArts. It's a fighting game with single and multiplayer support. It has your standard versus mode, arcade mode, different difficulty settings, etc. Nothing out of the ordinary except for the usage of Star Wars characters. Takes place between A New Hope and The Empire Strikes Back. And it's the reason this Teras tournament starts is because the Death Star was destroyed. Empire sought retaliation. Arden Lynn was hired as an assassin to assassinate key Rebel Alliance figures. So Luke Skywalker's and other Alliance members challenge Arden Lynn to Teras Kazu, unarmed combat discipline that many of you that are familiar with Star Wars probably know about. So it's taking the Star Wars license into the 3D fighting game genre. Given it's a 1997 release, it is a couple years into the lifespan of the PS2, so it's not too far into the lifespan. And if you want to pick up a copy of this game, it's easy to find for less than $10 in numerous places. But is it worth picking up for even $10? That's what we shall investigate. Let's go ahead and get the game footage pulled up. Get the standard Star Wars opening sequence. And Meg participated in this as well, helping to show, demonstrate the two-player combat. So I'll go ahead and let the intro scene play out. Apparently I cut the intro sequence. It wasn't much anyway, it's just a Star Wars thing. And then you have team mode, survival mode, versus mode, arcade mode, team mode, practice mode. You'll store records to a memory card if you have one. You have 8 standard characters you start with. You can choose from, and there's 4 more you can unlock.
Chewbacca versus Princess Leia.
End up with some weird... If you do arcade mode, you end up having to fight everybody, so you end up with weird fights like this. That make no sense in the context of the Star Wars universe. So as far as just the backgrounds, character animations, and even the character models for the most part, they look alright for a PlayStation 1 era game. And anybody that's a Star Wars fan won't have an issue with any of it. Unless there's something that violates the world. A lot of the fights, instead of being strategic like other fighting games, you end up just choosing to spam certain moves over and over. Given the delay sometimes occurs when you try to execute a combo, the fact that sometimes those combos don't execute at all. Also, unless you're fighting some entirely skilled, you absolutely need to jump. Usually trying to jump over somebody isn't even worth it, because sometimes you'll land facing the wrong direction, hitting yourself with a quarter to half second vulnerable to attack. The controls are rather sluggish. They're not sluggish in the way they're being like more... I guess they're sluggish in a way like Mortal Kombat was back in the 16-bit era. Except without the strategic
Mortal Kombat
had back then. give me a Tekken Virtual Fighter, Battle Arena Toshinden, and other
Chewbacca
fighting games that were
Luke Skywalker.
Better quality, that looked equally impressive.
Round one.
This game didn't
fight.
Stand out as much as Mortal Kombat 2 did when it was released. So here we have Meg entering the challenge. So yeah, as far as playing it with another person, it's playable. Even a single player, it's as far as the bare minimum bar that it does achieve, it is a playable game. It is somewhat fun when you're playing against other people. Environments do vary quite a bit, and look pretty good for the time of its release. There's lots of items, characters, and other things. A lot of things to unlock and secrets to find in the game. I guess I shouldn't say a lot, but there are some that are of interest, would be of interest for Star Wars fans. There is some issue as far as balancing goes between characters, considering that most of the time it doesn't end up spamming the same basic move over and over. Unless you're playing against somebody that's highly skilled at the game. Even then, you might just end up spamming
Chewbacca
the same attack.
Versus Han Solo.
You end up with a situation where people have a longer reach, whether it's a result of a weapon
Round
they have,
one.
Or
Fight.
Just from their size, have a huge advantage in the fight. There isn't really a whole lot of depth to this game. And given the AI isn't exactly the best, it really ends up being a short game to beat. And given that there's other fighting games that are better, this isn't really the game I'd recommend to pick up as far as a multiplayer fighting game. So what you have here is a game that's on the PC, it's from X-Wing and TIE Fighter on. Every Star Wars game on the PC is at least average. And a lot of them are all-time classics, like the Knights of the Old Republic series, the Dark Forces, the Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy, Jedi Outcast. You have the Star Wars Galaxies, the MMO. You have a lot of classic Star Wars game licensed games on the PC. Some of those also came to console. In varying degrees of competency and reports.
Final round. Fight.
Yeah, there's Rogue Squadron, Starfighter, Galactic Empires, Galactic Battlegrounds. Public Commando, Rebellion, there's many other Star Wars games just for the PC alone. Some of those are also on the PlayStation 1. There's even other games that play better that are PlayStation exclusives, or at least console Star Wars games. The only thing that really makes this one unique is that it's a Star Wars game, it's also a fighting game. There has been at least one other Star Wars fighting game released since. It's the only one that was around at the time for the PlayStation. As far as reviews elsewhere, game rankings, it's 53%. Game Informer gave it 6.75 out of 10. GameSpot, it's a 4.4 out of 10. And IGN rated 4 out of 10. But there were some places that actually. There's one magazine that had it rated as one of the best 5 Star Wars games of all time when they compiled that list in the early 2000s. Like I said, it's a playable game, but it's playable. There's a little bit of fun to be had, but
Arden Lin versus Luke Skywalker.
One of those games you play for a half hour and throw it back on your shelf and it just becomes a novelty item
Round
if you're really into Star Wars. So, what is our score for this game? First off, unless you're trying to complete a Star Wars game collection, I can't recommend this one. There are worse games out there, but this one just isn't that good. I'm going to give it a 4 out of 10. Kind of below average, but playable. Wrong of our reviews. I'm going to put it below Bart vs. the Space Mutants for the NES and above which it for the PC. It's a concept having a Teras Kazu, having a game that's built around Teras Kazu. Interesting idea, but lousy execution. So I'll go ahead and let the gameplay footage play out so you can watch some more of that and see some lightsaber action. Here you have Luke Skywalker fighting the main antagonist, Arden Lin. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the review. Please like, subscribe, and enjoy the rest of the video.